than now.
Thank you.
sugar.
Oh man. What, ham? Wait, yes. Because I did it in this. So, I just had this. So, all excited about that. Okay, yeah, that works. Yeah. But then when he, you know, here's a real life. So I said, you're up there. Yes. And he said, oh, my God. Yes, you are. But I said, you're wearing a dress. And I was like, I don't think so. I think the one only to your sister. And she was in some of the kids. She wasn't supposed to be there.
And she did.
And she did.
Oh.
Clarke Cast Crew president. The Clarke Cast Crew was created this past semester to give Clarke students the opportunity to perform in theater. This event is very special to us because it is not only the Clarke Cast Crew's kickoff event, but it hones in on that student aspect of a student organization. And that is because our play tonight was written by these two sophomores, Kayla Weller and Sarah Tyson. Kayla Weller is a sophomore. She is majoring in psychology, and she is a player on the women's basketball team. Sarah is also a sophomore, and she is majoring in K-12 art education with a special education endorsement. Both Kayla and Sarah serve on our executive board as our treasurer and vice president. And additionally, we have Emily Manneman, who is a junior on the pre-PT track, and she is our secretary, and she is up there. Hi, Emily.
Hi.
And so, please give another hand for these girls as they explain more about the process of building the show and the show itself.
So it's been a quick process. It's about a 45-minute play, so it's quick. We'll get you in and out.
Kayla and I were actually friends last year, and then we became roommates, so this was like literally 10 p.m.
Okay, I'm not using this. Here you go. All right, so Kayla and I were roommates. We actually came up with this idea at like 10 o'clock at night, and we wrote the first two scenes that very same night we came up with this idea. And yeah, that's kind of like what we started with. It was like a quick turnaround. And it was right in this final, so it was kind of fun. We hope you enjoy it. Our theme is an Easter family dinner. You know how family is. You love them.
We can get into this process a little bit more. We're having a talk back after the show where you can ask questions. We want to get on with the show. So yeah, if you want to stay a little bit longer for the talk back, we'll let everybody who doesn't want to stay leave, and then we'll reconvene and we'll talk a little bit more if you have any questions about the process of the play. I know we have a lot of students here who are here for extra credit opportunities, so if you want to know more, that's your time. As far as that, did everybody check under their seats for a little Easter egg?
Thank you. media and great guests. I can't hear you over the gate. Great. It just got interesting.
Paid for.
Jeez. Come on, JP. Let's
out of here before Gramps throws the remote. You know how he gets when the Cubs are behind.
Good idea. Let's go.
Now, girls, I just want to let you know I love you both equally, but I've decided to redo my will.
What? Is there a reason for redoing it?
Well, it's just been a while and some revisions are necessary.
What took you so long?
We're gonna go to two different stores, Grandpa.
Didn't mean to interrupt. Just left my sports book in here. In the cabinet.
Yes.
Jeez, kid. Whatever you find, and whatever you're looking for, don't let me know. A beer.
Actually, I'm not that thirsty.
But you always drink a beer with me during our family dinner.
Yeah, but I've been trying to cut alcohol out for a while now. Thanks anyways, Dad.
Of course, Bowie. How's the game?
It's all right. They nearly lost again. It's all because of the bad throws. I've been waiting nearly 8 years for them to get back to the World Series.
Maybe this year to make it.
I can only hope.
Well, gosh darn it! Bowie, can you come in here for a moment, please?
Ooh. Coming. Where are you?
In the study.
Where?
In the study. Clean your gosh darn ears out. Have you seen the divorce agreement? I just got off the phone with my lawyer and he needs it the day after Easter Sunday.
Last I knew it was in that top right drawer. Is it not there?
No, it's not. So where did you move it to?
I didn't move it. Well, I grabbed my sports book earlier. Was it on top of that?
about what happened in this study? I mean, he kept looking at Danica earlier. Do you think he's going to tell her?
Whoa. Relax. Just about the game. All right? There's nothing for him to tell Danica.
What's up?
Still haven't gotten your phone fixed? Anyway, I just wanted to see how your Easter's going.
It's going okay. Family's a little tense, but oh, geez, hang on a sec, Grant just walked in.
You got
your
girlfriend?
Haven't told your family yet? I thought you told them a month ago. Seriously, we've been dating for years now.
Do you got a girlfriend?
No, look, Corey, I'll tell them soon, I promise.
Wait. You're out! Well, thank God. You were taken forever.
Scotty, what happened?
Oh, she was up. Hold on. Hey, I'm gonna have to call you back. I'm sorry. You were saying?
What happened? Are those Fran's dentures?
Yeah. They're stuck.
I can see that.
Jesse, we'll finish our discussion later. Will you please go grab the first aid kit out of the closet? I guess I'll talk to the madman.
Jokes, because my husband's
Dad, you can go together, and Marge and Uncle Benji, you can go together.
And what about me, Scotty? Leaving me to die because I'm old?
No. You can jump from group to group whenever you see one. It's your house, you know the best.
Y'all's marriage doing pretty good.
Well, it was, but lately we've been fighting over the smallest of things, and I was so sick of it. We were actually sick of it. But just please remember, your marriage is so special.
I'm sorry you guys are having problems in your marriage. I'm glad you told me this. Since we are sharing secrets, I guess I should tell you mine. I'm pregnant.
You're pregnant? I'm gonna be an older brother?
Hey, I haven't seen much of you today.
Yeah, well, you know how the holidays are. You know, I've been trying to talk to my mother all day, but she is just not interested. You know, it's not just my fault I haven't seen you, though. You're always with JP.
Well, what do you expect me to do? She's our daughter. We hardly see her as is.
I don't know. Treat her like an adult. She is 20. She needs to learn how to survive on her own. I mean, we won't be here forever.
You were never truly there. You're always off for busy. I'm sorry I had a single parent for her whole life.
I want a divorce.
Oh, now you want a divorce? After all those years of you bringing home one man after another. Oh. Yeah, you think I was unaware of the number of men you bring to our bed?
You've been cheating on him after everything he's done for you, and you! You've known about the affair this whole time!
Sacred marriages are.
We didn't want to ruin the family dinner.
we discovered Dad's head on a silver platter!
I'll give her a break, Marge.
No, because I think Mom's the one who did it. Isn't it obvious? She just wanted to get the life insurance before she lost everything.
Now you watch it, Marjorie Jean Phillips, or I swear.
Not Phillips for long.
What is that supposed to mean?
We're getting a divorce, too.
Of course you are.
Why, though?
Your father's been having an affair with my wife.
Oh.
Sorry, Annika.
Tell me this isn't true.
Oh. How can you do this to me?
It was my older sister. And you, how can you do this to me after I found out I'm pregnant?
You're pregnant?
Yeah, but you would have known if you cared for me or even respected me, let alone my marriage.
I have always been second to you in everything. In life, in love, and in this family. Mom has only ever cared about what you have going on in your life. I'm sorry that for once in my life, someone finally cared about me more than you. And that person happened to be your husband.
Oh. You're ridiculous. I have always loved you both equally. I have never favored one of you over, you know, the other.
Now that is a load of crap, and you know it! You've only ever been to one of my soccer games. In a year. And yet, you've been to every single one of Danica's performances.
Oh, yay.
A mother should admit her mistakes instead of slapping her child.
Oh, that's rich coming from you. You can't even comprehend your mistakes with JP. You are the reason we are losing her every day. Do you even know about the substance abuse?
Why didn't you tell us? You could have helped.
Well, I could have spoken. We have to tell her.
How dare you cheat on my daughter?
You
are.
Good evening, everyone.
Now is the time in our show where you get to help. You get to help Saul, who killed me. I will present to you your lineup. You have Holly, my very, very angry, hateful wife. Family, maybe just a little too much. And then you have our wonderful daughter, Danica, our favorite child. Shh, don't tell Marge.
I already know.
Anyway, we have Benji, our son-in-law, who we wish was our real son. And JC, our granddaughter, who severely needs our help. And last but not least, we have our grandson, Scotty, who may or may not have some skeletons in his closet. The choice is yours. Choose wisely.
Thank you. take my controllers. Marjorie Phillips, Blake Murphy, you are on your list. Y'all have the right to remain silent. Anything y'all say or do will be used against y'all in the court of law. Y'all have the right to an attorney. If y'all cannot afford one, one will be sent to y'all. Do y'all understand these rights?
It's soon to be Mrs. Marjorie Murphy, officer.
Yeah,
oh, shut